अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ मैम तहमीना। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टीचिंग प्लॉट स्ट्रक्चर थ्रू शॉर्ट स्टोरीज। बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग इट, आई वॉन्ट टू गिव यू अ मैसेज। नेवर अनाउंस योर मूव्स बिफोर यू मेक दैम। लेट अस स्टार्ट आर लेक्चर। टीचिंग प्लॉट स्ट्रक्चर थ्रू शॉर्ट स्टोरीज। वॉट इज प्लॉट? प्लॉट इज द लिटरली एलिमेंट दैट डिस्क्राइब्स द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अ स्टोरी। It shows the causal arrangement of events and actions within a story. Plot is that type of story in which there is cause and effect element. Types of linear plots. What is linear here? Linear is related to chronological. Chronological means when events are in order according to their time and date. Plots can be told in chronological order, flashback, in media, when the story starts in the middle of the action without exposition. So, chronological order, when events are in order according to their dates and according to their occurrence. Flashback, when memories are recalled. This is the way when a story is written. In media, when the story starts in the middle of the action without exposition, we can say that this type of story is that story in which the story starts from the middle of the action without any exposition. Pyramid plot structure. The most basic and traditional form of plot is pyramid shaped. This structure has been described in more detail by Aristotle and by Gustav Freytag. Let's see Aristotle's unified plot. Triangle. The basic triangle shaped plot structure was described by Aristotle in 350 BCE. Aristotle used the beginning, middle, and end structure to describe a story that moved along a linear path, following a chain of cause and effect as it works towards the situation or solution of a conflict or crisis. So Aristotle unified a plot which has a proper beginning, middle, and end, and there is also conflict and solution in it. Freytag's plot structure. Freytag's pyramid. Let's see: exposition, rising action, climax, falling action, and resolution. Freytag modifies Aristotle's system by adding a rising action. Rising action can be complication and a falling action to the structure. Freytag used the five-part design shown above to describe a story's plot. So, Freytag added exposition, rising action, climax, falling action, and resolution. Let us see modified plot structure. Freytag's pyramid is often modified so that it extends slightly before and after the primary rising and falling action. You might think of this part of the chart as similar to the warm up and cool down for the story. So rising action may be warm up and falling action cooling down of the story. Let's discuss plot components in detail. Let's see what is exposition. Exposition is the start of the story, the situation before the action starts. And then rising action. Rising action, the series of conflicts and crises in the story that lead to the climax. And what is climax? Climax is the turning point, the most intense moment, either mentally or in action. Falling action. Falling action, all of the action which follows the climax. Resolution is the conclusion, the tying together of all of the threads. Here the writer tie all the events in threads and gives a solution. Conflict. Conflict is the dramatic struggle between two forces in a story. Without conflict, there is no plot. So these are the elements of a story, that there should be a conflict, proper exposition, start of the story, rising action, that is we can say that story is started and now it is moving ahead, and then it reaches to its climax, and then what happens, that falling action that follows climax, and there is a solution or resolution at the end. And the conflict is only very important in a story, because two forces fight in a story, and then a conflict rises and it reaches to a climax, and after that we can say there is a solution or resolution. Types of conflict. There are different types of conflict. They can be interpersonal conflict, human versus human. For example, a person has prejudice against another person. A person becomes selfish and he feels something negative about another person. Human versus nature. So nature is against human, or human is just against nature. Human versus society. Human is against the society. Maybe it's a criminal type or crime type stories. Internal conflict, human versus self. So internal, there may be or should be internal conflict, human versus self. A person is not in a good condition. He has some psychological problems. So students, you might have understood the plot components of a story: climax, exposition, rising action, falling action, and resolution. Okay, see you next time. Allah Hafiz.